What is up, guys? Welcome to another video. So I'm not gonna lie, the other day I was sat around the garden having a barbecue with the family, having a few beers, feeling a little bit sorry for myself because of the old gout, and I thought I'm gonna treat myself. Licking granny trainers is a thing, right? Or if I just completely made that up and I've just licked my shoes for no reason. Can't really afford to get hepatitis along with gout. I'm sure I'll be fine. So yeah, got myself some new trainers, because to be honest with you, the only real shoes that I own are these and like Sabo deadlift shoes. I don't really own many shoes. Like, a lot of the ones that I did own have just like worn away, so I've just got rid of them, and I haven't really treated myself to getting something decent. And to be honest with you, with my foot at the moment, with it swelling all the time, I needed something a little bit more comfortable. So I sound like an 80-year-old man saying I'm buying for comfort over style, but that is genuinely the case. I just wanted something which was going to be super comfortable. I think they look pretty good. I mean, they come recommended from my younger and much cooler cousin, so he said that he has a pair of these, and yeah, I really like them. They are the Adidas Ultra Boost. Be good for just like being able to actually walk more than 100 meters without my foot hurting. So I think overall a good purchase. Probably could have gone a size up because this right side is a little bit tight, but I think they look pretty good. They're pretty comfortable. So yeah, can you tell I'm approaching 30? Literally no sense of style. Just if it feels comfortable, I'm wearing it. Not that all 30-year-olds are unstylish. This nearly 30-year-old is definitely unstylish. So, training-wise today, I'm going to be attempting to deadlift and bench. Bench shouldn't be a problem, but deadlifts is just going to be a bit touch and go. Not as in touch and go, as in I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to do it or not. So, prepping myself with a lot of pre-workout. I've got my Ghost Lemon and Lime, which is slowly becoming my favourite pre-workout, with some creatine, and then topping that up with some naproxen, just to make sure that I'm not actually in pain when I get to the gym. But The last few days, today, the foot isn't feeling too bad. The last few days, it has been dreadful, and this flare-up has lasted a lot longer than the first time, which is really annoying. Obviously, I couldn't squat on Saturday. So yeah, we'll see how we get on. Deadlifts, I'm working up to 252.5 kilos, so it is the heaviest deadlift of this block and the heaviest deadlift I've done for a long time. I feel like I say that quite often, but obviously as the program is progressing, I'm just lifting heavier weights and lifting weights that I haven't been used to for a while. And on bench, I'm working up to 155 kilos, which I think is 98% of my one rep max, so I'm hoping to move that really well. To be honest, I'm benching first, I think. So that shouldn't be a problem with my foot, and then we'll just judge deadlifts after that.
New shoes.
Okay, let's go to the gym. Can you tell I'm approaching 30?
You're so old. When you were a kid, rainbows were black and white.
Got a car just about to crash into me. One sec. I'll be honest with you. When I actually bought the trainers, I was about 3 or 4 pints deep. So they do actually look a little bit different to what I remember them looking like. But I still like them, but they are actually quite tight as well, so I might actually have to go a size up, so I might be sending them back. So what I initially thought was a very good impulse buy might actually turn out to be not so great. So maybe I need a sober mat to have a proper look and have a look what trainers to get. But I mean, they're nice, but I think they're just a little bit too small and not exactly how I expected them. So back to the drawing board. Where the fuck has my phone gone?
bench felt amazing, so didn't have any problem with the foot during it, so I think I'll be okay with the deadlift. So I'm going to work up to 252 as planned. Feeling really good today, got a lot of energy, but yeah, we'll just see how we go step by step with the deadlifts. If anything feels wrong, I'm just going to stop. So, I think I've probably lost about 25 kilos worth in water weight this session, just because it is ridiculously hot today. I haven't stopped sweating, but it's been an absolutely quality session. 2.5 moved really well. It felt like a bit of a grind at the time, but actually looking back at the footage, I'm really happy with it. My grip was going very, very slightly. I managed to hold on to it, and the back down south sets felt really good as well. So 195 for 5, which again is one of the heaviest back down sets that I've done for a while. So yeah, I mean, moving in the right direction and a brilliant way to finish off the deadlift. So I presume we're going to now restart and then build back up again, and then closing in on the big 260. And in terms of bench, it felt the best it's ever felt. I mean, 155. I even misgrooved it, and it still felt unbelievable. So I was just so confident, I didn't bother even asking for a spot or an unwrap. Just felt confident going up to it and getting it done. So granted, I was a little bit more hyped up than usual, but it absolutely flew. I genuinely felt I could have benched over 160 today. So stands me in good stead again for the next block, where I presume I'll probably end up hitting 160. So all good signs, just slowly chipping away, getting to the numbers that I want.
Thursday today. Now, ordinarily I would be deadlifting today, but we've restructured the program so that I'm deadlifting earlier in the week, and then we're doing the SSB in the middle of the week rather than at the end of the week. So it's a good chance for me to finally use my SPD knee sleeves that I've bought. So I get to see the difference between brand new SPD knee sleeves and ones that are about 5 years old. So yeah, it's the first time that I've actually been able to, or that I'm going to be able to use these since I've bought them, because of my old foot. So that's going to be quite interesting. And speaking of buying things, I've been on a little bit of a spending spree today, and I've actually bought some new trainers, because I've decided that I am going to be sending back the Ultra Boosts. So for literally less money than the cost of one pair of trainers, I've managed to buy two pairs. So I've got some black Adidas here, which I absolutely love, and these I'm absolutely in love with. So just some Nike white trainers as well, so I'm going to be wearing these in the gym today. Anyway, enough about my bad financial decisions. Let's go and squat. Alright guys, I think I'm gonna pretty much wrap up the video there, because it's Friday today, and I'm actually on my way to my mate's stag do today, so I'm not gonna be training over the weekend, just need to go and drop off the Ultra Boosts in the post office, and I was having a quick look at them, and I'm actually... Football's coming home! Sorry. I was actually looking at them, and I was actually pretty gutted that I'm getting rid of them, because they are actually quite nice. Having a proper look at them, I really like them, but I can't afford three pairs of trainers. I just can't like justify spending that money. So I'm going to send these back, and I am happy with the other pairs that I got. So yeah, just quickly going over this week's training. It's been quality at the beginning of the week with bench and deadlifts in particular. Yesterday was quite a light SSB day, just building that back up, but that felt really good as well. No real issues with my foot, so yeah, all good signs. So Monday I'm going to be getting my blood results back, so that's when I'll know if there's any sort of adverse effects in my blood, if that makes any sense, if there's any problems with my kidneys or anything like that, which is affecting the gout. So yeah, I'm just gonna have to wait until then. But yeah, that's pretty much it for the video. I haven't really got much else to talk about. I would film the stag do, but I don't think that's a very good idea, and I don't think all the lads would appreciate me just with a camera filming them get increasingly pissed. So I'm going to wrap up the video here. I hope you guys have enjoyed it, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care. Peace. Friday, yeah. Saturday, Sunday, what? On my way. You're on the way to the windscreen.